Good evening. Welcome to St. Hyacinth. Today we celebrate the 26th Sunday of ordinary time here at Eden. Because we are on safety ground, please remember to silence all electronic devices at this time. Our entrance song will be found on the cover sheet of your worship aid. Here I am, Lord. Please rise and join in singing.
Thank you. O God, who manifest your almighty power above all by pardoning and showing mercy, bestow, we pray, your grace abundantly upon us, and make those hastening to attain your promises heirs to the treasures of heaven. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
Remember your mercies, O Lord.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Philippians. Brothers and sisters, if there is any encouragement in Christ, any solace in love, any participation in the Spirit, any compassion and mercy, complete my joy by being of the same mind, with the same love, united in heart, thinking one thing. Do nothing out of selfishness or out of vain glory. Rather, humbly regard others as more important than yourselves. Each looking out not for his own interest, but also for those of others. Having you the same attitude that is also in Christ Jesus, who though he was in the form of God, did not regard equality with God something to be grasped. Rather, he emptied himself, taking the form of a slave, coming in human likeness, and found in human appearance. He humbled himself, becoming obedient to the point of death, even death on a cross. Because of this, God greatly exalted him and bestowed on him the name which is above every name, that at the name of Jesus, every knee should bend, of those in heaven and on earth and under the earth, and every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Prostitutes are entering the kingdom of God before you. When John came to you in the way of righteousness, you did not believe him. But tax collectors and prostitutes did. Yet even when you saw that, you did not later change your minds and believe him. The Gospel of the Lord.
The big question that the church asks today is, how is your faith demonstrated? How do you demonstrate your faith? Now, I can give you perfect examples of how faith is demonstrated so far in this church. And I call it the greatest magical show on earth. There is a man, there is a woman. And they come together, and they love each other, and they have googly eyes for each other, and they get married. They come to the church to seek to get married by the priest, and they want to do all the things that are right. They want to have the beautiful wedding cake, and the beautiful dress, and the tuxedo, and they come to church, and they say their vows, and they march down the aisle, and poof, the magic show happens. They disappear. And then, maybe a couple of years later, we see the same couple come back with a beautiful child, and they say, "Father, we want to have our child baptized." And so I say, that's wonderful. Let's go through the classes, and let's demonstrate this and have the child ready for baptism, and you pick your godparents, and all these things happen, and they come and they get their child baptized, and then they walk back down that aisle, and poof, they disappear. And then 7 years later, oh, it's time for First Communion. Oh, Father, we want our child to have the sacraments in the church, and we want them to receive the body and the blood of Christ. And we will help them in their classes and to help them learn their prayers. And when that wonderful day comes, they're sitting there proud with their child, and the child walks up and receives the body and the blood for the first time. And the child walks back down the aisle and walks to his parents, and they walk out the door, and poof, repeat after me, poof, they disappear. A wonderful act in the magic show. And then, 7 years later, we're ready for confirmation. And the parents say, yes, we want to have our child confirmed. Our son, our daughter, we've talked to them. They want to move ahead with their faith, and we want to encourage them. And so we will have them in these classes, and they will show up, and they will do what they need to do, and the retreat, and they will learn the gifts of the Holy Spirit. And that one beautiful day comes when the cardinal comes and lays hands on them and anoints them, and they take that picture with the cardinal, and they smile, and then they walk back down the aisle, and what happens? The great magic show. The reason I tell you all of this is because we have reached the point in our gospel where Jesus is talking to his disciples. He's talking to the people in the court. He's talking to all these people, telling them that faith needs to be demonstrated. It's just not about what we say. It's about what we do. And Galatians put it very well when it says, Each one must examine his own work, and then he will have reason to boast with regard to himself alone, and not with regard to someone else, for each will bear his own load. Each of us will be held accountable for what we do, and we can give Jesus all the lip service we want, but if we're not having action behind our words, then it means nothing. And Jesus is basically giving us an example of what it means by just giving lip service. We have the two young men in our gospel reading in this parable. One says, yes, I will do the will of the Father, and does it. And the other one says, no, I won't do it, but ends up doing the will of the Father. And Jesus plainly says, the person who's doing the will of the Father is the one that's blessed. So I want you all to think about how you're all here receiving the body and blood of Christ. How you're doing the actions of God. But are you demonstrating your faith? It's very easy to receive the sacraments, but is it easy to live it in our lives? Are we demonstrating what God is implanting in us? Those gifts that he gives us, the graces that he gives us. When he's saying we're called to forgive and to show mercy and to show love, are we demonstrating the sacraments that we're receiving? Because Jesus died for each and every one of us. And he's calling us to live the life that he died for us to live. In 1 John chapter 3, verse 18, it says, children, let us love not in word or in speech, but in deed and in truth, because we're called to be not only the hearers of the word, but the doers of the word. And so today, I want you all to think about how you're called to demonstrate your faith. Or, if you want to just be a part of the magic show. And what happens in the magic show? And you're gone. Amen. As a community of faith, we say, I believe in one God, one God, Father of all, Maker of heaven and earth, all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true light from true God, God sorrow for sin requires a change of heart and attitude. Let us ask God's grace to follow Christ completely and for all of our needs.
For the church, for humble hearts committed to the Father's will, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all public servants, that they faithfully discharge the responsibilities of their offices. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For peace and harmony within and among all Christian communities. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all communities affected by severe storms. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all those who have been affected by the pandemic. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For the repose of the soul of John P. Sabinoso. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For God's blessing on all the faithful departed. We pray to the Lord. Especially the intentions that we hold in the love and silence of our hearts. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Loving Father, hear the petitions of your sons and daughters who seek to do your will day by day. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Lord,
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed, in and room he entered his passion. He took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it.